Hey there, I'm Jeff Kaufman, and today I want to talk with you about some additional questions that you may want to ask if you're someone who's looking for senior housing for a loved one or looking for senior housing for yourself. These are questions that apply during this pandemic that may help you in your search in finding the best place. So let's get started. I actually have five questions that I want to give you to ask places as you're looking for senior housing. I've already made a video on the top questions to ask senior housing in general. This is a video more specific to the coronavirus and the current pandemic that you could add to that list. I'll add a card to the top of my screen that you can tap on if you want to see the other video. These are more specifically coronavirus type questions. So let's get started. Ask the facility if anyone, residents or staff or anyone in the facility at all has tested positive for COVID-19. Along the lines of testing, ask how often they're testing their employees and their residents, if there's any routine testing, or is it based upon symptoms or at all. The next question is, ask the facility what their response plan is if they do get a positive case of COVID in their community. Nursing homes, which are federally regulated, must report any positive cases of COVID to their family members, their residents, and their employees. Assisted livings are state regulated, so it could vary as to what the requirements are for your assisted living if they get a positive case. What you need to find out is what is the company's policy around this. The next question that you need to ask is, what is the facility doing to encourage socialization and maintain socialization in the facility during this time? Facilities in general are being asked to practice social distancing, not have guests come into the properties, no visitors, things like this. But what is the facility doing extra to help the residents have some social outlet? We're seeing more and more evidence that as dangerous as the pandemic is, it's just as dangerous to socially isolate elderly or anybody during this time. Someone who might deal with depression or anxiety, this could be the worst thing for them. So ask about what the facility is doing. More and more places are getting extremely creative to keep their residents engaged. Ask the facility what they're doing to prevent the spread of the virus and prevent it from getting into the facility. I think any place could have every protocol in place and follow all the rules, and they could still get COVID-19. There's no way to 100% prevent COVID from coming into a building. In most states, assisted living and memory cares are not allowing visitors into the facility. But this isn't the case for everybody. Some places are allowing visitors with masks to come in. They're still touring their properties. Some places are still doing personal assessments, which is where we go out and we meet a family and we meet the residents and we put together a plan of care and go over all the different care types. You don't have to do it anymore that way. You can do it through a video call or just over the phone. It's too dangerous to go into unknown places like people's homes. You don't know how safe they've been, or other facilities or nursing homes for that matter. At this point, I hope most places have increased how they sanitize their facility. But a lot of places allowing visitors are creating a danger that's not necessary and also not recommended by the CDC. So ask this question, because if preventing COVID in a building is important to you, then a place that's allowing visitors to come in is not the place you should move. And number four is, if the facility is to get a positive COVID case, now you know how they communicate, but how are they going to respond with that resident? How are they going to prevent the spread of the virus? And what are they capable of when it comes to giving care? Can they care for someone with a positive COVID right there in their facility, and how will they do it? Ask this question. Your loved one could very well get COVID once they're in a building. You probably won't be able to visit them. It's absolutely horrible. And you want to know their policies and procedures around these things. You have to make your best decision when it comes to your loved one. You have your priorities and what means a lot to you. I'm not trying to tell you what to do, but I am trying to tell you what to ask so that you're well informed. Moving to senior housing has always been so difficult for families. In my 17 years of senior housing, I'm yet to meet someone that says, yay, I can't wait to move into this assisted living facility or this nursing home. And so with as hard as it's been over all of my years in senior housing, helping families get over the hump to move in, it's incredibly difficult now. Stress levels are maxed out, anxiety is at its highest. Families know that when they move in, they may not be able to personally visit their loved one again, or very limited at maybe an end-of-life type situation. It's horrible. But we all know that, and we want to help you through it. It doesn't stop the fact that you still may need it. What I'm hoping is that the videos I've created help you lower your stress, make you feel better, get you more prepared, so that when it comes time to make this move, you feel a little bit better. I want to thank you for watching this video. If you got to this point, you may like it a little bit, so please hit that like button and also subscribe to my channel. I upload content on a regular basis.